And now I'd like to introduce my absolutely beautiful actors, Kate Winslet and Liam Hemsworth. Thank you all so much for coming. So I'm going to speak because Liam doesn't want to. Just to say, on behalf of all the actors in this film, myself, Liam, Hugo Weaving, Judy Davis, I mean, make a noise for that. And lovely James McKay, who's in the room, who plays William, who you'll see in the film, you're about to see in the film. Joss, we're all very honoured to have been a part of your post 18 year comeback. And we hope you enjoy the film. Have a laugh.
Movie, you're a character who tries to really just transform a person's character, personality. So can you explain how costuming really helps you kind of get your acting flow or anything like that?
Well, costuming actually, I mean, particularly with this film, but with every film, it's the last of the piece of the puzzle. Because often by the time you come to the first day of shooting, you know, you've been thinking about the character and prepping the character for a month or so and, you know, really getting excited and figuring out who they're going to be. And of course, you can't really ever do that until the costumes go on. And so for me, actually, it's a really big, very exciting moment when the pieces start to come together.
All right, and final question is, the movie to me kind of reminds me a little bit of like The Scarlet Letter as the person's kind of, you know, your character's just like an outcast in society. So how did you get your inspiration for your character to be alive?
Well, the book, written by Rosalie Ham, it's such a wonderful story, and it's very, very rich and extremely colourful in the way that it's written. So actually, I spent a lot of time in the book, read the book several times. But in terms of really getting into character, you know, a lot of kind of picture reference and research into the fashion of the time, which was extremely important to Tilly. But also just working a lot with Jocelyn Moorhouse, you know, we had a really lovely collaborative relationship, and I had been attached to the film for probably just a little over a year until we actually came to shooting it. So there was so much discussion between the two of us, and by the time we came to start filming, you know, we both had a very complete picture of who we felt that Tilly should be, and I'm very lucky to have people like Liam Hemsworth and Judy Davis and Hugo Weaving, you know, really support the story and bring the character to life as well.
So you are the writer-director?
I am. All
right. Okay. So the movie reminds me a little bit of The Scarlet Letter. What inspired you to write this? Kind of, you know, she's
well, actually, it's a marvelous book by Rosalie Ham. And when I was sent the book to see if I wanted to adapt it, I, first of all, was really excited by the visual possibilities of having these extraordinary 1950s haute couture pieces set against really dusty one-world town in the Australian outback. And I thought I could have so much fun cinematically. But then I kept reading and I discovered characters, Tilly and Molly, the mother and daughter, and it just moved me so deeply. Their journey back together, because, you know, the mother and daughter have been separated for so long. So I was really moved by that story, but I also thought it was hilarious. And that's exactly the kind of movie I like to watch, and that's the kind of movie I want to make. So yeah, I felt like I was meant to direct.
And what was your favorite scene to write or direct?
I guess it would be the wedding. I'm trying to give away too much, but it's got like so many different emotions in it, and yeah, that was a really satisfying scene.
Are there any difficulties with writing period films?
Yes, you have to do a lot of research, a lot, if you want to be authentic. Even though it's kind of magical realism, it doesn't have to be completely real, but I still felt set in the 50s, I don't want to break too many rules about what was around that and what trailers.
My final question for you is, how was it to work with Kate?
Oh, well, Kate and Liam are just remarkable artists. They're just so good at what they do. It's kind of like if I was a conductor or I was a musician, it's like I had a couple of Stradivarius.
Hi.
They're brilliant. They were fantastic with each other.
Hi.
Gorgeous chemistry.
How do you
really
see Charlie Chaplin?
Lovely.
Thank you so much.
Well, we have a big family office.
I have a couple of questions for you, if I may. Do you prefer period films as opposed to modern day films?
Oh, I think I've done a bit of both, actually. Because, you know, the funny thing about period films is unless the themes and the ideas are contemporary, they don't work. So, you know, the period really is just how you dress and do the design. But at the end of the day, you know, a period film still has to work with very contemporary themes.
And so what was your favorite part about filming this film?
Oh, look, the whole thing was just a wild challenge. Can you imagine, you know, getting those gorgeous frocks out there in the middle of the Australian outback? You know, that was really, really special. And seeing something that we'd always imagined for years come to life, you know, when you actually saw those fabrics and the actors, you know, in that completely bizarre setting.
And look, you also have an Australian accent, isn't it?
Oh, I'm Australian, absolutely. I grew up, you know, on the plains, you know, that big wide outback. This is where the story began. So the author of the book, Rosalie Ham, and I came from the same little town in the middle of nowhere. So in many ways, this is kind of a little story about a little village and what happens when you come home after, you know, a long time away. And everybody around the world can relate to that.
All right. And how was it working with Kate and Leon?
Oh, wonderful. I mean, you know, they're just great actors. You know, to see Kate Winslet and Judy Davis in the same movie together is just like nirvana. And then to bring, you know, the gorgeous Liam Hemsworth into that mix. And, of course, yeah, they had so much fun. You know, you can just see it. You can see that it's a pleasure that they get as actors. But, you know, it comes through on screen when actors are really, really at the height of their game and enjoying being in the movie together.
And my final question is, what's next for you? What's the next
movie? Oh, well, the next movie, I'm working with Jocelyn again, and this time we're going to tell a big love story, and it will be a period film. So you're quite right. You know, I've got an interest in the period. Fabulous props again.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Lovely to meet you.
Hi. Hi.